What do you think? I mean, is there anyone out there who thinks these things are looking dangerously overboard now?
Well, there might be a few, but I mean, I think if we look at the, we have to look at the picture as a whole. I mean, it's bond yields, which are very low. It's not only bond yields, treasury yields, gilt yields, they're all very low. If you look at real yields even, so if you subtract from expected inflation, they're even very close to zero or negative. So in that environment, if you want to go for some sort of yield, you almost have to go out the credit spectrum. It's not only peripheral sovereign debt, which is tightening in, it's corporate debt, it's bank debt, it's pretty much the whole spectrum.
So when you're looking general at these pickup assets, how do you pick and choose when you look at the periphery? Which ones do you like right now?
Well, we certainly still like Spain. We have been liking Spain for quite some time, and as I said, it's not only the sovereign. So we do like the sovereign certainly, but we also like the banks. We think there's particularly the senior debt. We think there is more tightening to come. But in general, everything that has a pickup at the moment in the sovereign space still looks attractive.
Yeah.
Clearly.
You say the banks. Do you mean across the border, or are you talking Spanish banks?
No, we like Spanish banks in particular. Yeah.
Okay, all right. Greece talking about coming back to the market, of course, as well. One, do you like Greece? Two, do you like the Greek banks? Or when will you start liking the Greek banks, do you think? And do you think, I know Moody's is talking about an upgrade, do you think Greece deserves it right now?
Yeah, well, it probably does, a small one, because, I mean, there are various shades of grey, but we have to keep in mind that in the whole peripheral spectrum, Greece is still by far the poorest credit out there, and it's not going to change very dramatically over the next coming years. That being said, it is also still the highest yielding asset, so there is clearly an attraction, and against everything I said just a second ago, these spreads will probably come in as well.
Yeah.
But I'm still not a big fan of this particular credit, to be fair.
I mean, we're looking at what about, I think it was just up at 6.13 there or something on the 10-year Greece. I mean, can you foresee this, or can you see a time when this gets down to, say, 3.5 over the next 12 months?
Well, 3.5 is probably a bit aggressive. We gotta keep that in mind. But certainly, I mean, if the economy improves further, and if the public finances improve further, and if all the other peripherals keep rallying, then certainly this will come down. Not to 3.5, I would certainly hold my ground there, but probably lower than 6.
Okay.